Keshane Thompson's big dreams for the 2024 season. Nane Taylor-Thomas is back and ready to run. Jaden Hibbert brings the heat in the freezing cold. And Adele Tracy talks dyslexia. Welcome back to the channel, people. Welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, thank you for making it Peter Lloyd World. Go ahead, please hit the subscribe button so we can continue to grow. When you do that, hit the notification bell so you know when the next video drops, you drop a video at least once a day here in Peter Lloyd World. Also, if you enjoy the content, please hit the like button and finally leave your thoughts. So, are you ready? Yep, good to go. Well, we have to say happy belated birthday to the remarkable world under 20 world record holder in the men's triple jump, Jamaica's remarkable Jaden Hibbert, who most recently won the 2023 Male Athlete of the Year Bowerman Award. It was his birthday yesterday, people, and we missed it. So you know we have to big him up. Happy belated birthday. And we have to say the tradition here at Peter Lloyd World is happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday. Happy, happy birthday. Happy birthday. Hope you have a great 2024 season, Jaden Hibbert. Bless up. Do go check out our new channel, Peter Lloyd World of Wealth, if you desire to become financially literate, then financially free, and ultimately wealthy. Check us out. We will leave a link in the description below. Our newest video is up. It is entitled 3 Steps Out of Financial Hell. Welcome to the movement. If you are here, you are special. Because you want to achieve financial literacy, then financial freedom, and ultimately wealth. So check out the video if you want to get out of that financial hell. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button and please subscribe to the channel. Help us grow. Join the community, because you know what we do here. It's about the community, Royals. Link in the description below. Jamaica's middle distance runner Adele Tracy, a national record holder in the women's 1500 meters, was guest on the Hidden 20 podcast recently. And she talked about her battle with dyslexia. I really think you should listen to this. I found this really, really interesting. She's such a brave and remarkable young talent. Post stated, middle distance runner Adele Tracy thrives in chaos. Well, Adele, you'd love running a brand new social media platform during a podcast launch. Adele Tracy joins on the Hidden 20% podcast this week. Listen wherever you are and get your podcast. Here are some of the things she shared on that podcast.
So I was diagnosed as dyslexic when I was about 7 or 8 years old. All of my immediate family, my brother, my sister, we're all neurodivergent. But I was actually then diagnosed with being dyscalculic.
What a horrible word it is to say.
I would say it's essentially dyslexia for numbers. So this is from the summer, from the World Championships in Budapest. I think I almost thrive in environments that other people would consider to be quite stressful.
I think I almost thrive in environments that people think might be quite stressful. That's a great, great attribute to have if you are a top tier athlete. This young lady, I think, is going to have a great 2024 season. She's improving with each and every run. And it's good to know that Natalia Gould Toppin and Stephanie Ann McPherson have company there. We need more middle distance runners like Adele Tracy. Thought it was really, really interesting, her being so open and honest, talking about dyslexia. Something that many, many Jamaican people and Caribbean people have, people globally have, and were unaware of. I remember someone I knew, I grew up with, who had dyslexia. And them used to say him dumb and him fool, because they didn't understand what dyslexia was. Just found that was very interesting. Hope you check out that podcast. Big up Adele Tracy. Lanae Taylor-Thomas, who started to rep for her country again last year and came third in the women's 200 meters at the 2023 National Championships at the National Stadium, but was unable to represent the island at the World Championships in 2023 at the Budapest World Championships, that is, over the 200 meters. because her transfer, I think the gate had not, the transfer time had not been yet approved. She should be able to run for the island this year officially. She's a tremendous 400 and 200 meter talent and long jumper, by the way. Not sure if she's going to be doing any long jump for Jamaica, but that should be interesting. And well, she's back and opened her season recently, of course, indoors. She posted to her social media pages, and so it begins. I'm expecting big things from this young lady. I think she's an incredible talent, and happy she's running for Jamaica. Now, on to Kishane Thompson. Last year, he exploded on the scene, running a PB of, and the fastest year for a Jamaican male, by the way, in the 2023 season, running an incredible PB at the Xiamen men's 100 meters finals against the likes of Christian Coleman and his fellow Jamaican Akeem Blake, where he ran a new PB and the fastest time for the 2023 season by a Jamaican male, a time of 9.85. Shocked everybody actually at the National Stadium, where in the heats he ran and won in the heats, 9.91. Didn't turn up for the semis or the finals, and therefore he did not represent the island. Found out later, of course, that his coach, Steve Francis of MVP, had pulled him and said he was going to do some special work with him. So let's see what if Steve Francis has now found the secret sauce to creating a world male sprinting champion. We know he's great with the queens. Let's see if he's been able to do it with the king. Now, in a recent interview, Kishane Thompson had this to say about his dreams for 2024. In an interview with the Jamaican Observer, he simply stated, and I quote, "The plan for this year is to go harder than ever and to stay healthy and to show you guys what I can do." What can he do? Here he is running that is incredible 9.85 in Xiamen, shocking the entire world.
Great start from Coleman in lane four. Fabulous start. Oh, and Bracey Williams has gone back. Akeem Blake, in fact. But look at this. The running here from Christian Coleman. He's not going to be caught in this day, or is he? Wow.
After a slow start, Kishane Thompson is just pure fire once he hit that 40 meter mark. Clearly, what they'll have to do is work on his initial speed when he gets out of those blocks. But I think that maybe finally MVP and coach Steve Francis has found the secret sauce. They have created what looks to be a potential international sprint superstar. Please, coach Francis, have this young man run the 200 meters. I'm going to be harping on this for the entire season. Please make him run some 200 meters. What are your thoughts? Do you think Kishane Thompson can achieve his dreams? Do you expect big things from this young man? I'd love to hear your thoughts. Now, don't forget to go over there and support our new channel, Peter Lloyd World of Wealth. Also, big up to Adele Tracy. Awesome interview. Go check it out. Awesome talent. And of course, what are your anticipations for Lene Taver Thomas in the 200 meters senior women for the 2024 season for Jamaica? Also, one more time, happy belated birthday to the remarkable Fortis alum, the remarkable Jaden Hibbert. No, I was head boy for Kingston College. Now, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, hit the like button. Remember, your royals, kings and queens, bless up.